In this video, you will learn how to scrape list information from Bing step by step. So if you want to reproduce this tutorial, all you need to do is to download Octoparse if you haven't done it already. The link to download it is in the description. My name is François and welcome to this new tutorial. The first thing we need to do is to make a research. So in our scenario, we will be looking for results related to web scraping. Once you are okay with your keyword, you copy your URL and you paste it on Octoparse. But now the first thing you can see is a huge pop-up, and that's pretty annoying. I assume you want to remove this pop-up. Well, actually, I do want to remove this pop-up. To do so, you turn on the browse mode and you click on accept. Basically, when the browse mode is turned on, you can navigate as if you were using a normal browser. That's often used at the beginning of your workflow when you want to change some settings directly within the website. If we directly scrape this page, we can only have access to very few data, like around 10 data. But if you want to have access to as many results as possible, we need to scrape multiple pages. So this is why we need to create a pagination. We click on the next page button, just like this, and we click on loop click single URL. As simple as that. Furthermore, for the Ajax timeout, I invite you to set up an Ajax timeout of 10 seconds. The higher your timeout, the more you let the website some time to load entirely. We are on page 2 now, and it's time to extract some data. Basically, you've got multiple ways to extract data, but I think the easiest one is the following. You select the block of the first element and you click on it. You repeat the same process for the second element, just like this. And Octoparse helps me. It indicates that there are around 10 elements within the page. All that remains is to click on extract text of the selected elements. And that's perfect. I've got my loop item and my extract data button. Now I can extract freely all the data I need. For instance, let's start with the title, extract text, and I've got my title. I no longer need the first data field that was just used to create the loop item, but I no longer need it. And this column will be called title. I can extract the URL, same thing, but this time I click on extract the URL and I've got my URL. I can also extract the description, let's say description, plus I can add some predefined data field. For example, I can extract the current date and time of extraction. There is something I haven't seen before. The workflow is not totally correct, because if I run my task right away, we will miss the first page. The first page won't be extracted. To deal with the issue, I need to drag the loop item just above the click to paginate button. And now the workflow is just fine. I save my task. So let's give it a name. For instance, Bing English. I save my task and I click on run. And as you might know, you've got two options. Run on your device is with the free version of Octoparse, or you've got run in the cloud, which is for paid members only. You've got a couple of additional features with this one, but basically the main advantage is that you can close your laptop and Octoparse will still scrape your data. Make your choice and let's see what the final result should look like. Data extraction is over. That was really, really, really fast. I export all my data in an Excel format. And here is our results. As you can see, things sounds pretty good. Hope my video got your confusion cleared away. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos regarding Octoparse and web scraping.
We will always keep you updated.